EA Sports. It's in the game. That was the perfect call out there. Once he got the block, he made a move, and he was headed to the end zone.
Spectators, and they've come out in full force for this one. A fantastic atmosphere here in Minneapolis. Today, it's a black and blue matchup in the NFC North between the Green Bay Packers and the Minnesota Vikings. Greg Joseph now ready to get this one started, and we are underway from Minneapolis. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Time to see the offense for Green Bay go to work. Aaron Rodgers leading them. What a career it's been. Came into the league back in 2005 as the number 24 pick out of Cal.
There have been very few quarterbacks in the NFL who have been as consistent throughout their career as Aaron Rodgers. He's been good for so long, and we've seen no decline in his skills. His accuracy and arm strength continue to elevate the talent around him, and his in-game mistakes, few and far between.
First play and a first throw for Rodgers, and that one off the mark behind him, incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes, but the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
Incomplete.
Oh, man, for him to be that wide open and drop it. Sometimes you have just too much time on your hands, right? You end up thinking way too much, and your hands get shaky.
And, yes, he's a tight end, but that's a catch he should have made. And, oh, that nearly an opening drive INT, but it does fall incomplete. Not the way he wanted to start this ball game, as it brings up fourth down. O'Donnell, he's on to punt as he gets this one away. Here comes Rager. A nice return that time, gets 12 yards back. And the Vikings will take over here, first and 10. Play action now, Cousins. He's going to find Jefferson open downfield. Touchdown, Vikings! Justin Jefferson, 58 yards. And the Vikings are on the board first here this afternoon. Both sides of the football in sync early. You force the three and out, and then you take it down, score points.
You know what that tells me? They sold their game plan really well. Head coach said, listen, we're just going to stop them on three and out. We're going to take the ball downfield and score. But he also told them how it was going to happen. They're going to run this. We're going to stop it.
Oh, and now they're going to fake it. And he is not going to make it. They stop him up short, and this will remain a 6-0 ball game.
So a sensational return there on special teams, a foot race that he was not going to lose. Now, meanwhile, while that was going on, we've got an injured player on the field. Well, the medical staff is going to come out here and take a look, and we will take a short break.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Packers offense here coming back out for their second drive.
These guys definitely hoping for a better showing than their last appearance. They couldn't really even move the football much beyond the shadows of their own goalpost, Charles. We'll see if they can get a better, more sustained drive going here.
Yeah, and every team that we ever talk to says the exact same thing. When you start a drive from that deep in your own territory, the goal is a minimum of at least 2 first downs, because even if you have to punt then, you change the field position, right? You flip the field a little bit. They didn't get that done. This time they want to string together a nice drive and help themselves out.
That one a broken play, but it ends up being a good play. The scramble goes for 20.
I am willing to bet that he got a monster grin on his face when he saw what was happening. Man covers were so committed to denying a big throw that it pulled attention away from him, and he had an easy lane to hit, and hit it he did.
The big play to start him out has him at the 45 already. Now the man from UTEP, this is Aaron Jones. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. The tackle made there by Harrison Smith. Well, if you look where that play starts, O-line versus D-line, that was a battle won by the D-line.
Yeah, and oftentimes it's won by quickness off the ball. Who can handle the guy across from them best? On that play, the defensive line did exactly that.
Here's Rodgers. Yeah, that went too far in front. He couldn't reel it in. It's incomplete.
And he's missed now in his first 4 passing attempts. The rhythm is just not there to begin this ball game.
The threat of a second straight punt to start the game is looming as they come up 3rd and 10. And that will be incomplete.
This defense has certainly played well so far in this game, and the coverage has been tight on just about every throw. Forced a few here so far in this game, and now it brings up 4th down.
And here's a very low line drive, almost whiffed on it. And this kick will be touchdown as they spot it inside the 45-yard line. The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway.
Well, partner, you know, coaches always say that every play is designed to score a touchdown. Sometimes that's not really true, but last drive, that was the case. One play to get into the end zone, and now they'll try to duplicate that success here.
And it's rare for those moments to happen. Incredible when they do. And you saw the celebration. Pure, unbridled joy after that one.
Throwing, Cousins. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. Kirk Cousins, an 8-yard touchdown run. And the Vikings are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead.
Another impressive drive. So they're 2 for 2, 2 touchdowns. Charles, a great start to this ball game for them.
And one of the words that's really worked its way into our lexicon is stacking. They've stacked momentum each time out, not only on offense. Between those touchdowns, defense held, forced a punt to get the ball back, and they played awfully well in this one. Both sides playing at optimum level.
Joseph connects on the extra point, and the lead now stands at 13. Well, it wasn't a one-play drive, but I think they'll take it. The scoring summary, two plays and into the end zone. Now Joseph tees it up to kick off following the touchdown. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Packers offense set to go. They've shown precious little here offensively thus far as they try again with a first down now. Now Rodgers. That is incomplete.
That's now six dropbacks, six incompletions. Yeah, the defense been pretty good early, but he's got to start hitting some of those throws. He's making them better than what they actually are.
Now Rodgers, a free play. And this one drops incomplete, but I think the defense jumped. And that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
Here's a second and five now after the offsides penalty. Now Rodgers. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Chandon Sullivan. And the Vikings are going to take possession of the football. So more problems here in this first quarter. Already two scores down, and here they give away the football.
And if I'm the head coach, I think it's time to start lighting a fire under some of these guys. Now, you have to do it within your personality. They can't perceive it as fake, but I'd go get after some guys. They don't look ready to play to me. They look flat, uninspired. It's time to get moving.
Following the interception, Cousins escaping the pressure. And he will score. Touchdown, Vikings. Kirk Cousins with his second touchdown in this opening quarter. As these guys have opened up a very comfortable lead. So, Charles, that's three touchdowns on three drives, and it's just been an offensive barrage so far.
Great word, partner, using barrage right there. I'm going to add another word, if you don't mind. How about perfection? No surprise that they're leading right now. Absolute dominance throughout this ball game, and no signs of slowing down.
Oh, and now they're going to fake it.
Admit I'm scratching my head a little bit here trying to make sense of what I just saw. Number one, huge lead. Just kick the extra point and be done with it. Number two, if you are going to go for two, just line up and go for it from the 2 yard line. Why make it so difficult? That's a long way to go to try and pick up some points.
Now Joseph tees it up to kick off following the touchdown. Nixon elects not to return it, and this comes out to the 25. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. They find themselves in a good size hole here, and a good size hole early on in this game as they come up on first down. Start out on the ground with Jones. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. It was Danielle Hunter to make the play in the backfield.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave them seven blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through. But that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
Now on second and 13. Rodgers, this one swung out here to Jones. And he'll go down just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Just a gain of a couple there. And that'll bring up a third and 11 situation. So he jumped as a safety. You might know a thing or two about that from your playing days.
Well, I remember creeping up near the line of scrimmage on certain blitzes or certain coverages. Never jumped off sides, though.
Not once?
Not once. I wish I had a few times. I would have stopped some of those plays I got toasted up on.
It goes as a gain of eight, and it moves the chains.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. On play action, now Rodgers. They'll roll him out right. And incomplete, he dropped it. Maybe a rookie mistake there, second down. After the incomplete pass here now is second and 10. Throwing now is Rodgers. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. But it looked like a Packer. Yeah, Packer was able to get this back, and they'll indeed keep possession. The good news, they kept the ball. Bad news, it's third and long. To throw is Rodgers. And that's going to be incomplete. The contact there enough to jar that ball free, and it brings up fourth down. So on fourth down, on is the punter, Pat O'Donnell, to kick it away. And he's getting a workout here in this first quarter as he gets it away. And this will be down just on the other side of midfield. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. But Charles, they're really stringing these possessions and scores together early. We're still in the first quarter, but if they can score again here, look out.
Yeah, and as you taught me when we're broadcasting games, one word we're supposed to avoid, and that's blowout. But that's exactly what's going on here. Down three possessions just the first quarter. That goes beyond any worst-case scenario we might have thought coming into this game. And another touchdown here, that should eliminate any hopes for any type of...
Got a man, it's caught at the six-yard line. And down he goes, taking... Inside the 10, just shy of the 5... Six. Now a chance to make that big play really hurt. It's first and goal just outside the 5. To throw, Cousins. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
They may be snapping a ball near the goal line, but all you're thinking defensively, keep them out of the end zone. Force the incompletion, force them into going for 3 and not giving up 6.
Second down and goal. Cousins, and it's caught. Touchdown. Kirk Cousins on the connection to Justin Jefferson as his guys are able to push that lead out a bit further.
Boy, still in the first quarter, and look out. I mean, they are on pace for over 80 points in this game. I don't know that they'll get there, CD, but this has been impressive to watch so far.
That certainly would be history in the making, wouldn't it, partner? I'm glad we're here to actually watch and see if it actually happens, although, like you, I have...
Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. He's got it at the 10.
I know they're not asking me, but I'll give you my opinion anyway. I think it's time to erase that play from the call sheet. I guess they figure with the big lead, they can experiment a little bit. But all in all, just go ahead and put that play on ice.
Now Joseph tees it up to kick off following the touchdown.
And they're going to mark that where it went out of bounds. So really good starting field position up past the 40-yard line. Well, you don't see that often. He just mishit it, and it goes out of bounds.
Well, I know sitting up here, and I'm looking at you, and you're looking at me, and I know we're both thinking the same thing. Isn't it easy enough to keep it between the sidelines? Because unless you're intentionally doing it for some reason, well, that's a costly mishit, and now you put your team in a bad spot.
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. We are in for a good one as we're through one on EA Sports. Rodgers to throw on second down. And that'll be off the mark, too far out in front, and it's incomplete.
Well, touch and time are critical for those types of throws. He put a lot of zip on that one. Needed just a little bit more finesse trying to get it to his back.
Throwing is Rodgers on third down. Flush to his right. And the throw there going to be incomplete. The passing game not in sync here early. And now it's fourth down.
All right, help me out here a little bit, partner, because what I'm seeing is a passing game that's just struggled to complete anything. No rhythm, no timing. Seems like every pass is also contested well, so give some credit to the defense.
Here's Pat O'Donnell on now to punt it away. Oh, it's a wobbler here. Yeah, that'll cross midfield here, not by much. Out of bounds just on the other side of the 50. With a glimpse of Justin Jefferson, the wide receiver, as he and the Minnesota Vikings return back here on offense. Making his presence felt early in this one. First half, already over the century mark.
How about the yards per completion, too? That's a pretty darn good number. Number of catches, but he's shredding defenses, getting big yardage with each and every one of them. Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking...